You talk about facing reality, at least by white America. Don't you think it's time for black America to realize that a great deal of its problems are trying to blame them on the past and white America? Isn't it time for blacks to face up to their own realities?
Well, I've heard that before. I don't think that black people can be accused of blaming their situation on the past or indeed blaming their situation on anybody. The situation is much too vivid, much too terrible for that kind of self-indulgence. But I repeat what I started out with. History is not the past. The situation in the black community in this country is abominable because this is a racist country. And every institution in this country is a racist institution. And the very last thing the Republic really wants is an autonomous black community. Everybody knows, for example, that if you build a school in a ghetto, you built a disaster factory. And the answer to that is not to bus a child to another neighborhood. The answer to that is to rebuild a city so that human beings can live in the city. Cities are not supposed to be built for money to make a few people rich. Now, we want to deal with that, we've got to go there. In the meantime, there's no point in blaming the black community for being upset about the community. Because the community has always been involved with the Republic. When we tried before, some time ago, there was a school strike in Harlem, which blacks and Puerto Ricans came into the schools, declaring themselves responsible for the education of their children. And it was a very successful strike. I was there, like the nieces and nephews in school. It was broken by the United Federation of Teachers and by the city, because they did not want, first of all, those billions of dollars, which is the education system. It is a billion-dollar business. They did not want that money controlled by blacks and Puerto Ricans. And that is what we're up against, and it's not the past. And there's no point in blaming black people for it.